and take advantage of a tough time for the tourism industry. How you can cash in on some great deals.
It's the big story at 5:30, a downer for Disney.
Yeah, the coronavirus is crushing their business. Late this afternoon, Disney announcing they lost $3.5 billion during the second quarter. The parks were closed for most of that. Fox 35's Amanda McKenzie reports.
It wasn't that long ago that theme parks were packed with guests before COVID shut them down. Now that they're back open with limited capacity, it's a whole new world.
Usually this time of year is pretty rough at the parks. Very long wait times, elbow to elbow people in, on Main Street, especially at Magic Kingdom.
Michelle Atwood runs the Main Street Mouse website and says there are deals to be had.
If you are staying at a Disney resort, it is very easy to get a reservation. Like, we could go, book a resort this weekend and pretty much have our choice as far as which parks we'd like to visit. But as an annual pass holder, you look at the app under that category, and like, we couldn't get in again, I want to say till the 13th, and it's Epcot. So your choices are very much limited unless you're staying at a resort.
While pass holders may be limited, the capacity limits do not appear to be maxed out. Disney's website shows there are tickets available every day this month.
I think there's still a significant amount of residual fear that are making people hesitant to go into those environments.
Over at Universal, the park just announced a way to get the most for your money.
Universal came out with this excellent promotion for Florida residents this week, which I think is a great deal. You buy one day, but then you can go unlimited times from now until December 24th. So I think they just are trying to get people interested, and save a little money as far as coming back to the parks.
At SeaWorld, single ticket prices are being slashed. Economists say if the bottom line for the theme parks don't improve soon, there could be more layoffs, fewer attractions, and surrounding small businesses could shutter.
If we do see the vaccine breakthrough here in the fall, I suspect you'll start to see bookings, both for leisure and business travel, begin to improve for 2021 very quickly.
In the meantime, more theme park deals could be coming to get attendance up. In Orlando, Amanda McKenzie, Fox 35 News.